Hi, it's me, Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut. At the beginning of 2022, I ran a poll on Twitter and on SurveyMonkey, in case you don't have Twitter, asking those of us that are spaceflight enthusiasts to make our best predictions about what we expect to see in the upcoming year. And believe it or not, we did pretty good, but we were definitely pretty optimistic about a few things. So just for fun, we're gonna do a little overview on what did and didn't happen throughout this last year and take a look and see how we did in the polls. Now, this is actually different from our Astro Awards. The Astro Awards are the thing where we kind of celebrate all the cool things that happened. Get ready, there will be the Astro Awards still at the beginning of the year. And we're also almost done with my over 1 hour long deep dive on how to start a rocket engine. So stay tuned, there's a lot more. So for those of you who caught last year's poll, I've got a link to that below so you can play along and see how you actually did. But I also have a link to this upcoming 2023 year's polls for both Twitter and SurveyMonkey. That being said, let's get started.
3, 2,
okay, first off, I asked you guys which of these three rockets will launch first between SLS, Starship Going Orbital, and Vulcan, and then we also had a none of the above. And this one was a pretty big upset for the 70.5% of you guys that guessed that Starship would actually be the first one to go orbital. As we know, it hasn't gone orbital yet, hasn't left the pad. And only 24.5 of you guessed this one right, that SLS would fly first. So as we know, SLS took the cake on November 16th, 2022 with a spectacular night launch for Artemis 1. It was amazing. Now I have to admit, I personally didn't imagine it was going to take until November to see one of these three rockets fly. And frankly, I kind of thought we'd see all three of them fly. So congrats to those of you that guessed that Artemis would fly first. Next up, I asked how many times did we see the Falcon Heavy launch? And only 24.2% of you guys actually got this one right, guessing that only one or two would fly. As it turns out, there is only one Falcon Heavy launch this year on November 1st, 2022 for USS F-44. And this was another flawless Falcon Heavy launch with that incredible dual booster landing, and it even had an expended center core, which helped the rocket loft the satellites direct to a geostationary orbit. Had it not been like the foggiest day I've ever seen at Cape Canaveral, this would have easily been one of my favorite launches this year. But unfortunately, we didn't really get to see much.
Absolutely insane. SpaceX, how do you do it? And why'd you do it on a foggy day? Couldn't you have gone one more day later?
Next up was, what's the furthest milestone that Boeing's Starliner spacecraft will make it to this year? And for this one, 52.6% of you guys actually got this one correct, that Boeing would do their second orbital flight test. It was the second uncrewed mission of the Starliner since the first uncrewed test was not successful in completing all of its milestones after it ended up having a handful of problems that plagued the mission. After a successful mission with OFT-2, Boeing is now eyeing their crewed flight test no earlier than April 2023. So what do you guys think? This is definitely one that's in the polls for next year. When do you think we'll see people fly on Starliner? Next up, we had a fun one. I asked you guys, will Rocket Lab successfully catch, recover, and relaunch an Electron this year? And now I have to say, when I made this poll, I kind of, in retrospect, I thought it was silly that I even said that they'll almost catch one. Like, what's that even mean? But come to find out, that's pretty much exactly what happened this year. So 19.7% of you got it right, but in a way, 59.5% of you, which was the majority, kind of got it right, because technically they caught it, they let it go, and then they did recover it still. But that's not really what we meant. You know, we really meant like catch it and never have it touch the water in recovering. At least that's what I intended to mean. So I'd say that 19.7% of you guys got this one right. Will they catch, recover, and refly one next year? Hope you guys are voting, because this is definitely going to be one we're keeping an eye on. Next up, we had, how many new launch vehicles will we have in 2022? Holy crap, if you actually count up how many brand new rockets, how many new rockets that were kind of versions of older rockets, but technically new rockets, we had a lot. We have Firefly's Alpha, SLS, Vega C, Zhilong 3, ZK-1A, Long March 6A, and Angara 1.2, all who successfully made it to orbit. That's absolutely unbelievable. But if we're talking about completely clean slate rocket designs, like ground up, it does get a little bit more complicated. Any way you cut it, we're still pretty close to having about 5 brand new rockets fly this year. And only 4.8% of us actually got that one right. I wasn't one of them. So congratulations to those 4.8%. The majority of us thought only one or two new rockets would fly in 2022. I think 2023 is going to be even crazier. Okay, so the next one is funny. We asked, what's the furthest milestone we'll see a super heavy booster do in 2022? Yeah, I don't think many of us saw this one coming. Unfortunately, I think we got spoiled by the progress and the pace we saw in 2021, and we just really couldn't even imagine a world where, frankly, nothing would happen this year. So yeah, this one was a bit of an upset for most of us. So unfortunately, 88.3% of us just couldn't really imagine we wouldn't see much happen at Starbase this year. And only 0.5% of you guys were pessimistic enough to think that nothing would happen at Starbase. Now, I don't think nothing happened at Starbase. It really should be more like none of the above. But hopefully we see a lot more action at Starbase in 2023. Okay, so this one's obviously a throwaway. The question is, assuming Starship / Super Heavy launches, how far will Super Heavy make it into orbit? And then I explicitly said, don't answer this if you don't think it'll launch in 2022. So as we know now, anyone that answered that question got it wrong. And again, I think I need to do a little bit better job here of making polls, because I also asked you guys, what's the furthest milestone we'll see of a Starship upper stage this year? And yeah, 1.6% of you guessed correctly that no milestone would be reached. Next up, we asked you guys which of these three smallsat rocket companies would make it to orbit first this year, including ABL, Relativity, and Firefly. And only one of those companies actually made it off the pad this year, and that was Firefly with their Alpha rocket, which launched successfully on October 1st, 2022. Unfortunately, ABL and Relativity didn't get off the pad this year, but both companies are poised to launch in early 2023 with vehicles on the pad, and with ABL having already had a handful of launch attempts, but unfortunately, all of them have been scrubbed so far. So the majority of you guys actually got this one right, with 68.4% of you guessing it was going to be Firefly. I absolutely love that launch. Obviously, I was heavily involved with the production of that launch, so it's pretty close to my heart. They will definitely be getting an Astro Award this year. Next up, I asked you how many humans would go into orbit in 2022, and we actually saw a minor downtick compared to 2021, with only 24 people making it into orbit this year. Now, there isn't any real particular reason for this. You know, half of it just kind of comes down to scheduling, but it turns out that 22.6 of you guys actually got this one right. Next up, we asked almost a bit of a trick question, but really it's plain and simple. How many Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy boosters will land this year? So this really wasn't meant to be like a gauge of how good is SpaceX at landing rockets, but it's really meant to be more how many missions this year would be expendable. In 2022, SpaceX only expended three of them. So they had a 100% mission success and 100% landing success, which is absolutely astonishing. This means that 95% of the boosters SpaceX launched in 2022 were landed, which only 30% of you voted for. 60.5% of us thought we'd see over 96%. Now, I do have to say it was pretty cool seeing them retire some boosters by just expending them, but it's just absolutely incredible that they had 100% landing success rate. Staying with the Falcon 9 and launching with SpaceX, we asked how many times will SpaceX launch something in 2022? Wow. Okay, I think Elon at the end of 2021 said something like they're hoping to launch 50 times in 2022, and I definitely thought that was just a completely optimistic goal. So yeah, I only put 41 plus as like the top number. I couldn't even imagine a world where we'd see over 60 launches or over 40 even this year, frankly. So the majority of us got it wrong because we guessed that there'd be between 38 and 40 launches. But 30.5% of you guys got this one right by guessing they'd launch over 41 times, which it just is, yeah, still crazy, but I doubt that many of you out there would have ever imagined they were going to launch 60 times this year. And the next one, again, is also about the Falcon 9 and SpaceX. We asked, what's the most flights that a single Falcon 9 booster will reach in 2022? So at the end of 2021, we had booster 1051 hit 11 launches on a single booster. But by the end of this year, we had three boosters reach 14 flights. And we had one booster, it was B-1058, that reached a 15th launch. So the majority of us were pretty close. There was 64.8% of us that think they'd get to 14 launches, but 24.3% of you got this one right, thinking that they'd actually get above that. Next up, I asked if you guys thought that Rocket Lab would test fire their Archimedes engine this year. For this one, yeah, 68.3% of us thought they would, and 31.7% of us said no. So unfortunately, as far as we know, they did not end up test firing an Archimedes engine in 2022. Now, although we didn't see one of those engines fired, we did get to see a little glimpse of the bulkhead for Neutron, which is kind of the section at the top of the tanks. And a picture of that compared to an Electron bulkhead, that was super awesome. In my opinion, it's really fun to start seeing some of this Neutron hardware appear. Next up, we tried to predict when SLS slash, you know, the Artemis 1 launch would actually happen. And believe it or not, the majority got this one right, with 46.5% of you thinking that it would launch in the second half of the year. That's fantastic. Frankly, I didn't care when it launched. I'm just so happy it finally launched, and it was amazing. Next up, we tried to guess how much further would Ingenuity fly on Mars. And, you know, this one was incredible because in 2021, it already far exceeded all expectations and all milestones. And coming to find out, it was kind of just getting started. In 2022, it went on to fly 19 more times for a current total of 37 flights and a total of 7.58 kilometers traveled on Mars. This means it flew 3.76 kilometers in 2022, with its longest flight being a whopping 704 meters. But it didn't quite reach that third option that we had in our poll. This means that 47.3% of you guys actually got this one right. This next one is probably the dumbest question I had on the entire poll last year, because I asked you guys, when do we expect to see the first images from the James Webb Space Telescope? Now, the reason this is dumb is because NASA literally told us before I even made this poll when we should expect to see the first images. Like, there was no chance of it happening before they said it was going to happen. So I don't know why this was even a question, honestly. The James Webb Space Telescope had a very precise deployment and alignment sequence that was down to the day. It was down to the hour, and I guess it was down to the minute. So it really shouldn't have been any shock that NASA released the first full images on July 11th, 2022, in a live stream featuring many of the scientists involved in the mission. Next up, we asked, when will we see a Raptor 2 engine installed on a vehicle? And the first time we actually saw an engine installed on a vehicle was in May of 2022. The first time we actually saw them fire an engine on Starship wouldn't be until August of 2022. So again, the majority at 36.5% of you got this one right in guessing when they're going to install a Raptor 2 on a vehicle. Not bad. Next up, we asked, what's the furthest milestone we expect to see for ULA's Vulcan rocket? And for this one, 43% of you got this one right, guessing that they would actually get their BE-4 engines delivered. But although both engines were successfully delivered to ULA this year, unfortunately, the rocket hasn't left Decatur as a whole yet. Now, sans any major issue, we should for sure see Vulcan fly in 2023. Next up, we asked how many lunar landers we expected to see land on the moon this year in 2022. 34.7% of us thought we'd see 2 lunar landers this year, and unfortunately, we saw 0. So 24.7 of us got this one right, predicting that we wouldn't see anything successfully land on the moon in 2022. But there's already a couple of spacecraft on their way to the moon as we speak. They're hoping to successfully land in early 2023. So hopefully there's a higher number in 2023. Next, we had another new rocket prediction asking, what's the furthest milestone we'll see for Ariane Space's upcoming Ariane 6 rocket? And again, the majority was actually wrong here, with 42.4% expecting to see a test of the Ariane 6 at the pad in 2022. It turns out the rocket has not been shipped to the pad yet, so unfortunately only 20.4% of you got this one right with quote-unquote no visible progress. Now I have to admit, no visible progress is a little bit harsh way of putting it, since there definitely was progress this year, but since it hasn't, you know, made it out the door yet, unfortunately, none of it has really been visible. Now on the same note, we asked you, what's the furthest milestone Blue Origin will complete with their new Glenn rocket? And here you were all pretty sure we wouldn't really see any visible progress similar to the Ariane 6, which is more or less what happened. So congratulations to the 54.2% of you who didn't think we'd really see anything happen. Unfortunately, yeah, that's the case, but I'm really, really hoping we actually start seeing some hardware head out to the pad here soon. Boy, oh boy, did this next one have a pretty major wrench thrown in it when I asked, how many times will a Soyuz rocket launch in 2022? I personally didn't predict that Russia was going to invade Ukraine, but I guess everyone else kind of saw the writing on the wall that the trends in Soyuz launches was going down more or less. Now, Soyuz would have launched a lot more if they would have actually been able to keep those OneWeb launches, but they lost out on that. So yeah, it turns out that 44.8% of you guessed correctly that it would actually decline with a total of 19 launches in 2022. Lastly, we asked you what you thought would happen with NASA's Double Asteroid Redirection Test, or DART mission. You guys nailed this one just like NASA did, because 86.6% of you guessed correctly that it would hit its target Dimorphos, which it did successfully do on September 26th.
And we have impact, a giant leap for humanity in the name of planetary defense.
This was a home run mission for sure, and we're definitely gonna be talking a lot about it in this year's Astro Awards. Overall, some crazy stuff happened in 2022, and we're gonna dive a lot more into that stuff in the Astro Awards in just a little bit here, so stay tuned. Because we'll dive even deeper into what did happen, all the fun things, but we'll also celebrate those who made it happen. And another reminder, if you want to take part in next year's video, check the links below. We've got some polls there for you. You can please just take one between either the Twitter poll or the SurveyMonkey poll, and next year you can play along and see how you did. I owe a really big thank you to our Patreon supporters for helping with this actual video, doing a lot of fun little things here with me, but also for just helping with everything we do here at Everyday Astronaut. If you want to support the work that I do, head on over to patreon.com/everydayastronaut. And while you're online, be sure and check out our awesome merch store for shirts like this, the Future Martian t-shirt, and lots of other really fun stuff, such as our schematics collection, the rest of our Future Martian collection, our dresswear line. Soon we'll have a restock of our Falcon 9 model rockets and lots of other fun stuff at everydayastronaut.com/shop. And like I said, be sure and stick around. There's not only the Astro Awards coming out, there's also going to be How to Start a Rocket Engine coming up soon. I've also got an exclusive tour with Stoke Aerospace and their incredible fully reusable launch vehicle they're working on. Lots of fun stuff we're gonna be ramping up here into Starship action hopefully soon. So stay tuned, there's a ton more coming. Thanks everybody, that's gonna do it for me. I'm Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut, bringing space down to Earth for everyday people.